sorry to keep you waiting, gentle shepherd. The Lord of Calamity and friends are here to see you.
I can't wait to strike down the world's greatest swordsman.
You picked a fight with the Ifrit pirate crew. Now we're here to finish it.
Lord Artorias, I follow my own will now, and I'm going to stop you.
In my sword lie the hopes of mankind, the potential for a perfect world. Do you really believe that will without reason can break it?
Your sword is strong! But it's still only a weapon, just like ours.
Why don't you test that theory? With your life, of course.
Ever since you hit me, I've had this really annoying feeling in my chest. But I can't figure out what it is.
Then I'll just have to hit you again and see if that helps.
I'm sure I'll feel better after I eat you.
Arthur! I finally have an answer to your question. Why do you think that birds fly? Birds fly because they want to fly. They don't need a reason. Even if their wings may snap and doom them to die. They don't fly for anyone's benefit. They don't fly because they were ordered to. Birds fly because they want to fly, and for no other reason!
So that's your answer.
Yes. Because that's who I am!
You were always like this. That sort of foolishness is what creates the demons and plunges the world into tragedy and despair.
Then you drive the demons out! Isn't that right, Shepherd Artorias?
That has been my plan all along.
Elements of God!
Gather! And hold
back!
Trouble shall be!
Stop!
single stroke. I will call death into your being. Savage! Wolf Fury! I can't!
Tenacious demons.
He's the reason, right there. I'll take care of you! Stand aside, Velvet. Not happening! Have my comb.
That was the comb that Laffy gave me. Not you, you know me not.
Of course. I'm Enominat, now reborn. And you're the Lord of Calamity. Oh, Artorias. I'm hungry. My stomach is empty. My chest is empty. My body is empty, too. It hurts. It hurts so much.
It looks like we won't be able to harvest despair by eating you anymore. Well then. Birds must fly. Because they possess strong wings. Mankind must be suppressed. Because it possesses great sin. Malevolence, tragedy, war, anger, tears, even love must all be suppressed. With the grace of my beating wings, I will grant humanity the tranquility it deserves. Enominat, come, devour my despair.
I shall suppress all creation!
Artorias was filled with this much despair?
Was he holding it in check this whole time?
One more step, and he would have become a-
No mercy!
Wounds I will see!
Let us settle this here and now, Lord of Calamity.
Struggling!
give up your fight. I will end the world's sadness. I have to end it!
Arthur's forgotten Maxim!
It's what you told me once, long ago.
On the day of the opening. Velvet. The Arthur you knew died that day. It was always there, in the back of my mind. If only it hadn't been Celica and my son who were killed that day. If only it had been you two instead.
I thought the same thing so many times. If it had been us, then I know you would have fought to save the world for us.
It's true. I wanted to save everyone. Such a pity.
Goodbye.
It's over.
I'm hungry. I'm hungry.
No, it's not over yet.
I'm hungry.
I'm so hungry!
No one is keeping his power in check anymore! This is bad!
We still have time to kill him!
Wait! I'll do it.
I endured it all, even though I was scared, even though it hurt.
I know.
I drank that gross medicine. I stopped myself from doing what I wanted to do. Eating what I wanted to eat. I tried so hard. Why won't you give me this? I hate you! I hate you, Velvet!
Luffy said, you tried really hard. But you don't have to fight anymore. It's time for us to rest, Luffy.
Velvet will let Enominat devour her forever, with her forever devouring him in return. She will seal him while keeping him alive. An infinite contradiction, a perpetual cycle of destruction.
Velvet, you can't!
You and I are part of Enominat, V. If he dies, both of us will die too. I dug my own grave. But you...
I don't care about myself! I'm not scared of dying as long as I'm with you!
Good. Then die. But only after eating, living, doing everything you want to in life. I really am horrible, aren't I? Just a selfish failure of a human being. But despite all that, you still saved me. With your unwavering kindness and strength.
I didn't do anything! Velvet, you were the one who...
Fi, you must have seen it during our travels. Humans spend their lives in constant struggle. That's why they end up making so many mistakes. Even my poor brother. That's why I'm asking this of you. Please live. I was the cause of so much chaos and destruction. Help the world I ruined. Help people like me. Help the weak. This is my last selfish request.
That's not fair!
I'm truly sorry.
Now you show up. Pretty irresponsible, if you ask me.
You were mistaken. Without Innominat, the balance of our power will crumble.
The elements will clash in violence and ruin. The world will take millennia to recover from the destruction.
No!
To save the world from destruction, a new Imperium. A Moloch of great strength, an indomitable will.
I'll do it. I'll be your new Empyrean.
Hold on a second, Lafayette! You can't just...
Let's hear him out.
You are part of Innominat. You're not lacking in strength. But the question here is one of your intent.
Just what do you wish for this world? What will you bring unto its denizens?
I want people to have another chance! A chance for them to right the wrongs born of their fallible spirits! To give those who dream of flying the time they need to rest their wings! So that in their strength, their weakness, their cruelty, their kindness. These imperfect humans will one day stretch their wings toward the horizon.
Make your dream a reality, young Imperium.
We're really back on the ground. The Dragon of Light!
Good grief. Velvet's recklessness rubbed off on him. Hasn't it, Lafayette?
Huh? Is that really Lafayette? But how?
That is his Empyrean form. It's also proof of his determination.
Like an oath?
Yes. Do I frighten you now, Eleanor?
Not at all. You've matured into a fine man.
So was that flame? Your true power as an Empyrean?
Demons. Malevolence. Did that fire get rid of it all?
No. I'm still very much a demon.
This silver flame has the power to cleanse a soul of its malevolence and change a demon back into a human. But it doesn't have the power to change people's hearts.
It just gives them another chance at life. Isn't that right?
Sorry. Looks like my sins run too deep to fix.
That's fine. It's a part of who you are, Rokuro.
You're still a softie, aren't you?
Well, that's just great.
Huh?
Most of the exorcists are wiped out, but the evil and chaos in people's hearts lives on. Gonna be tough going from here on out, folks.
Yes, it will. Even still. Humanity will never lose its hope or its prayers for a better future.
Well said!
The Malakim have free will again. Some may even lend you their aid to help create this ideal future of yours.
I will spread the word. This world is now under the protection of the Empyrean Lafayette.
Would you mind not calling me that? I don't think it really fits who I am now.
I guess you're right. That was Velvet's name for you.
Okay, what should we call you then?
Call me by the name Eleanor gave me. One who lives. That's what Lafayette means. Translated into the ancient language. This is not the end of chaos. It is the beginning. Mankind will go on fighting without end. Just as they did. Still spread their wings to seek the horizon, just as they did.
For every laugh, there will be tears. This world is cruel and unforgiving.
Hey, come on.
Even the gods themselves don't know what the future will bring. Kindle a flame within me, burning strong and bright.